This time of year, we get to have Tim Pinkney in, a.k.a. the Pumpkin Picasso. You got here about what time this morning?
Oh, 6.
6, okay. He's been carving ever since. And this is what he's doing. He makes three-dimensional pumpkin carvings. Kind of makes the rest of us look like slackers. actually, my 7-year-old, for the first time ever, is doing it on his own now. I hollow it out,
but
he's carving. So, I mean, he's a far cry from what you're doing, but there's hope.
You know, all it takes is a potato peeler, and that's all it takes, because he can do that, and you can just change your whole sculpture by just doing the pumpkin by using this.
And so, you get some angles that you normally couldn't get with a knife.
That's exactly it. They get much more gentle. Let me get the eyeball out of there. So that you can shape them into, you know, saggy eyes here.
Do you carve other kinds of vegetables when it's not pumpkin season
I did do watermelons this summer.
Oh, you did?
We're here on TV for you guys.
I remember that. Yes. Yeah, absolutely. You just reminded me. Now, what we're talking about today is maybe some of the places you can get inspiration. Like how do you figure out the kind of monster creature you're going to make here? Where do you draw the inspiration from?
First of all, it's the shape of the pumpkin.
Right.
And then from there, I do things I've used masks as an idea of maybe how I want to do horns or make sure the nose kind of thing or teeth and chin. Mm-hmm. I've used different models that I find around anywhere, so it's just being unusual.
How thick is the pumpkin? What would you call it? The pumpkin itself,
yeah,
I guess, right?
The meat of this. Get a close-up here. I'll show you that this is about... This is about...
Oh, it's pretty dang deep.
At the top, it's the deepest.
Okay.
And we're just about ready to go through there, but you see, I have
quite a bit to work with, because that would be my thing too. Am I going to go through here and then I'm just ruined? Or I bet you've done that before and just incorporated it into the look.
Of course, there are no mistakes.
No, of course not. That's what makes your job so perfect. And you're also doing something different here too with the skulls.
Well, I walked in the studio. They had this as part of your demonstration, and I thought, wow, this is just great.
That's cool.
Idea. So I'm always looking for eyeballs. I've used Christmas ornaments. I've used vegetables, kind of squash, gourds, so that sort of thing. And you need a bigger pumpkin, because this kind of pumpkin that you get at a standard supermarket is only this thick.
Right. You didn't do this one.
I did.
You did this
But
you did this one just to show kind of the differences between the two.
And
yes, this is impressive, this is a bit more impressive, too.
And this kind of pumpkin you can get out at the pumpkin patch on... Kenneth, right between Madison and...
Like big old pumpkins.
Big pumpkins. Madison and Greenback on Kenneth.
So, Tim, you're going to keep on doing your thing here. Now, I noticed, do you have some food coloring back
here? Well, I do have food coloring.
So might you color a little bit when we come back?
I was going to put food coloring around the gums here.
Cool, perfect.
So I'll have that done by the time you get back.
Very good. All right, Tim. Nice to see you. And I think Deirdre or Lisa are going to be out here with you next up. But it's always a pleasure and just such a cool thing. All right.
Fun time of the year.
It is that time of year.